Would you please stand? And now the end is near, and so I face that final curtain. My friend, I'll make it clear. I'll state my case, of which I am certain. I lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway, and more, much more. I did it. I did it my way. Jean Belcher Parrott did it her way. She was what we call determined. She did it her way. And I know this time is tough whenever you have to say goodbye. Someone that is a constant, someone you love, it's always a very difficult time. But scripture tells us in Psalm chapter 34, verse 18, it says, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Would you join me as we pray? Father God, Almighty, giver of all the good and perfect things, we thank you for this opportunity to get together and celebrate the life of Jean Parrott. God, I ask right now that you give us the right words and the right heart and the right spirit and the right memories. God, to where we can do her life justice. Because she meant so much to so many people here. God, bless our time together as we give everything to you and your glory. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Before I sing this song, looking at the words on the front of this piece of sheet music, the prayer attributed to Dr. Reinhold Niebuhr. We all know it as the serenity prayer. God, accept, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change those things that I can, and wisdom to know the difference. I believe those words are such a comforting word at times as we have here today. And I want to thank the family for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this service. Just me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, that is worse now and then. Pushing and shoving, crowding my mind. So for my sake, Lord, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a
born in the middle of a Great Depression. You had to be lucky and tough as an adult to make it through. But as a kid, you had to be lucky and tough and blessed and stubborn to make it through. Those were tough times. And Sonny and Charles and Gene, people would say that, you know, times were simpler then, and those were good times back in the day. Going and milking cows, and planting what you eat, and harvesting, and cutting wood every day, and figuring out how you're going to feed your family, and how to make ends meet. Those weren't, it may have been a little more simple, but it wasn't easy. Those were tough times. And those are the times that they grew up in. Milking and plowing and harvesting. Jean told me that she didn't have to do it. She didn't have it near as bad as the boys did. Because she was her daddy's princess. And she had to do some things, but she said they had it a little worse than she did. She was a little more spoiled all through the upbringing. She went to Oxford High School and finished, and then went to Miss Fuller's business school here in town. And she really took to keeping books. She loved numbers, and she loves making the ends meet and the cents accounted for. And stuff like that would drive me absolutely insane. Some people love it. And she was one of those people that really took to it. Because she was determined. We would say stubborn, but determined sounds a little more dignified. She told me that she did not want her funeral to be sad. She said, get on with it. And that's what we're going to do today. She was determined to make all of those pennies and cents add up. And she became so good at it. And all in the meantime, she fell in love with the love of her life, Sam, or Sham, as some of you call him. He sold Fords. She kept books. The furniture store, the A&P, You remember the old little perch at A&P on the side where it had a little elevated offices and she could sit back and kind of watch what was going on? That was her spot. She monitored everything that was going on. Keep an eye on it. I have heard from multiple people that she was the queen there. And she sat up on her throne and said hey to everybody that walked in. They had a good life. They had good family. They had good friends. Right here in good old Oxford. Even if Robert sold Chevrolets, they used to battle back and forth between Fords and Chevrolets. And you have your particular brand, which I'm sure you like Coke or Pepsi better either. So it's all up to you. But they had good friends in Robert and Eunice and the Cottrells and the dinners and the trips to the lake. And they made such good memories and stuff that she would talk about often. I've only known Jean for a couple years now since I've been pastor at Del Reno. And I've got to know her visiting her in the nursing home. But she talked about her friends and her family so often. And she loved church. She loves Del Reno Baptist Church. She loved teaching Sunday school. That was one of her things. She loved it. She loved the kids. And she loved making the kids have a good time. And she told me a lot of stories about my congregation that I love to tell on them all the time now. It makes it fun. I get to remind them from time to time. She loved the kids so much that she would play with them. And Belinda even said that she would often kind of push Belinda to the side and she would be the one playing kickball or dodgeball or hopscotch or jump rope or whatever they played. And she would do it instead of her. And she would compete just as hard as anybody. She loved teaching the kids about Jesus. And she loved teaching them the Lord's Prayer. And if you would, right now, would you please recite that with me? It's a model prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. They said, Master, teach us how to pray. And he said, it goes like this. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen. We talked about that prayer often. And she talked about it. And when I met with Belinda and Bruce and talking about her memorial service, she said that she really liked the Lord's Prayer. And she told me for 2 years now that she really liked the Lord's Prayer. We would often pray together before I left. You see, the great thing is that prayer is found in the book of Matthew. It's also found in Luke. Two writers with a little bit different take on the same prayer, the same words. You see, in the words of that prayer, they were prayed by Christ Jesus himself as the model prayer. Pray like this. And family, that prayer will get you through the next several days and weeks and months ahead. And I know you will miss Mama, Jean, Grandma, sister, aunt, cousin, friend. I know that we will all miss her because she was such a constant. When you live to be almost 91 years old, you are a constant. 91 long good years. A constant that was definitely determined. And I know that we'll all miss her. I know as a family, you guys will miss her. You can't go there and see her. You can't pick up the phone and talk to her. You can't take her this. You can't go see her. But what you can take with you is the love And boy, did she love y'all. She loved her family. She talked about you guys often, and she would list everybody on the pictures on the walls. And we would talk about brothers growing up, and we would talk about family and friends. But you can take with her, take with you the love she shared, and take with her, take the memories of her with you wherever you go. 90 years is a lot of memories. Most of you here, you don't know life without her in it. It's a long time, but you have to take with you those memories. The fact that she would drive around town with 6 or 7 packs of butter in her trunk to keep them warm so they could be ready to make a pie or a cake. Ready for the next occasion, the next death, the next family meal, the next time she was ready. With the butter in the trunk for pound cake and cheese straws and yeast rolls and sourdough rolls. And thank goodness she did, because the word is on the street that when they were young, that if it wasn't for Jean, Laura Jean and Brian would have starved to death. Thank goodness she cooked so much. I know the stories, guys, that Jean and Shem would stop at nothing to make sure that y'all were all right. You had everything that you needed. They would give you everything. Hold to those memories. The card-playing game. I don't know if y'all gambled or not, but I know that y'all played cards a lot. The ball games on TV, the bowling league. Yeah, I didn't know until recently that she loved to bowl, which makes me smile every time I think about her bowling. The beach trips, the weekly out-to-dinners to where you would go this place on Wednesday, and you didn't ever change that, ever. We went to Hardee's in Clarksville on Wednesday because we go and buy scratch-offs before North Carolina got the lottery. And then Friday, you went to the old place in Townsville. And you didn't go to Hardee's on Friday, you went to Hardee's on Wednesday. And then Saturday and Sunday was somewhere else. And if you were there with them or you're around them, you saw that the pattern in their life was the same, and they loved the routine because it was part of the determination that made her who she was. She never, not one time in almost 91 years of life, ever put gas in her own car. I'm sure it was her brothers, or daddy and brothers, and Sam, then Bruce. It's cute. 91 years, and you never put gas in your own car. Remember those things. Talk about those things. Talk about the stuff that nobody else knows but you and her. Because I promise you, you have those things. Now is the time. Family and friends, it's the time to get together and share those stories. Let her life matter, because it did, because this is your bloodline. This is how you got here. Honor that. She is responsible for you. As her independence started to fade, and she needed more help, she had to go into an assisted living facility. But she still maintained her determined self, even in the assisted living facilities. I heard about one aide, Claire, calling her the hall monitor for years. And she would easily insert herself into everyone's issues or problems, being determined that she was going to fix it. She definitely liked things her way. Her clothes a certain way. Her hair a certain way. Her chair a certain way. And especially the bed covers and pillows. a very certain way. You see, the brothers couldn't do it. Bruce couldn't do it. Belinda could do it some, and Julia could do it really well, I hear. Remember those things. Remember the Yeti full of the special 7-Up at Christmas and holidays and birthdays. Remember those things. Remember that it's okay to want a hamburger from one place, fries from one place. And we all know Cookout has the good ice. And she wanted it from the place with the good ice. This is the time to cry. It's the time to laugh. It's the time to talk and share your memories. But today, as you leave this memorial, this time that we celebrate a memory, I want you to remember the favorite prayer that she often modeled. Her favorite prayer that she loved to talk about, that she loved to teach. It says, "Our Father." It's giving homage to the Creator, the one that is the creator of all, showing him respect. "Our Father who art in heaven," where is he at? He's there waiting for us where she is now. "Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, special are you." She would teach this prayer is the name above all names. "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done," right here as it is where he is. Focus on things that are kingdom-minded. Focus not on things of this earth, because we are all living in a life that is but a vapor. And eternity comes for everyone. "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Give us this day our daily bread. Don't worry about the future. The future might not be here. Worry about what's in front of you right now. Tell somebody you love them. Hug their neck. Shake their hand. Care a little more. Love a little more. Because tomorrow may not be here, because this life is so short. Even 91 years is short compared to eternity. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our trespasses. Try to live a holy life. She would want you to remember to live the best life you could as we forgive those who trespass against us. Don't let petty disagreements get in the way of anything, because it's just that. It's petty disagreements. Because in the scope of pain, in the view of forever, none of it matters. She wanted you to know that. Forgive us of our trespasses. Lead us not into temptation. Be aware. Deliver us from evil. Take care of us, God. She knew the Father would see us through every situation in our life. The kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Give him praise and glory every day. She believed that. She taught that. She prayed that. And I can assure you that her family and her friends, she prayed for you all the time. She went to God on your behalf. Talking about grandkids and great-grandkids and friends and family in our church. I'm going to miss someone praying for me. So somebody else, you need to pick up that slack and start praying for your family. You see, I know her health had been failing. And I know that almost 91 years is a long time. And no matter when we know the train is coming, we're never really ready when our loved one has to get on. But you see, the great part, and Lord have mercy, there's a great part. You see, people like Jean, who believed and accepted what Christ Jesus did for them. What he did for me, what he did for you. She accepted that, accepted the power of his blood and what his death meant. It meant the opportunity for eternal life. And all you have to do is accept it and believe it. And he wants to do a wonderful work in your life, in your heart right now. And I know the next step after this life is to be in eternity with God. Apostle Paul says to be absent from the body is to be in the presence of the Lord. And you see, I know your hearts are heavy, and I know you hurt. And I know people have come up to you guys and they've said, I'm so sorry for your loss. But you see, something is never lost if you know where it's at. I know through the blood of Jesus Christ where Jean is. So there is hope. So much hope in knowing what comes next. She knew what was next. She was ready for what was next. She was tired. She was worn. She was weary. She was ready. Are you ready? Because that's the question that I know that she would want you to be asked right now today. She is with God right now. And she would want you to know that Jesus Christ died for you. And the only way to the Father is Him. She wants you to know that she loves you, that she prayed for you, and the hope for eternity is she gets to see you again. Family and friends, she loves you dearly. She truly loved everything about her family and her friends. But just know, she is at peace, she is at rest, and she is whole. She feels good for eternity. Join me as we pray. Father, right now, as we celebrate the life of Jean Parrott, God, we thank you for what she has meant to so many. We thank you for letting us be a part, even a small part of her life. God, right now, as we see that the family is hurting because their constant is gone, you know what it feels like to lose your son. And so right now, God, will you please be with the ones that have lost their friend, their mother, their sister, their grandmother, their great-grandmother, their aunt, their cousin. God, because we loved her so much, there's a hole there. There's an emptiness that only you can feel, God. But we know that your scripture tells us that you will give us peace beyond all understanding. And we need peace right now. We don't understand how we're going to get through without it. Especially the ones that love her most. God, we ask right now that you wrap this family up. That you fill them with your Holy Spirit and wrap them up and let them feel your presence like never before. Please comfort them. Please carry them. Please hold them for weeks. Turn into months. Turn into years. God. And we thank you for what Jean meant. We give you all the praise and all the glory in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
may be dismissed.